Emerson! Don't worry, we'll make it. As long as this works, that is, if... Emerson, wait a minute! Oh, dearie me, I must have lost him. Well, that's what happens when you enter in your own time stream. Only God knows what happens next. Like that. Is that what I think it... The TARDIS! Oh my word. This is the Titanic, isn't it, huh? I'm not alone after all. Doctor! Doctor, let me in!
What?
Doctor, please just let me in!
No, it can't be.
Thank you! I know, it's strange meeting me, but there's no time to lose!
Wait a minute, hold on. What's the big rush? Doctor? What's happened to you? Tell me, this shouldn't happen. Unless... you're absorbed into our time stream. But no one's supposed to do that. You're bloody insane.
Look, I understand that you're mad.
Mad? Oh, we're beyond how I'm feeling. Do you have any idea how many laws of the universe you've broken? Or has our massive ego got in the way of knowing? Has another companion left, is that it?
Died? Actually, but this is nothing to do with this. I had no other choice.
Oh, you had no other choice. Well, let's definitely clear things up. Why didn't you say so?
Look, if you think I'm bad just for entering the time stream, and then I can 100% guarantee that you won't be infatuated with the man after me.
Doesn't matter. Listen, it was nice to do this doctor meets doctor routine again, but I don't want to know why you're here. Us, and of all people, should know that not even a Time Lord should stay in their own time stream for too long. Now I'm going to ask this in the nicest way possible. Eject yourself from our time stream, so you won't risk the timeline.
I can't, Doctor. Not yet, anyway. There are more important things at stake. The whole Earth, even. Please. You have to help me.
I'm sorry, but it's going to take more than Earth is in danger excuse to convince me. Even if you're facing the Master, that's not enough.
All right, then how about a future version of us?
What do you mean?
At some point in your future, we're all getting injected with something we shouldn't have. Something perilous and hazardous. And I think you know what I'm referring to.
Dark regeneration energy.
I'm afraid so.
Can't be. And I assume you have no recollection of our encounter when you were with me.
Not a speck. That's because he... Well, we used quantum travel to trap me in an eternity bubble. I only managed to escape using the Eye of Harmony to get here. But I got separated by someone named Emerson on the way.
Never mind that. What do you want me to do about it?
By my precise calculations, he's in the year 2026, doing God knows what. You have to help me stop him. You're the only one who could take me to him, to cease this madness once and for all.
Do you realize what you're asking? You're not asking me to interfere in our future, but also operate as an accomplice to you transmuting our time stream.
I know it's a lot to ask, and I wouldn't have it if I didn't have to, but Doctor, many will suffer because of us. Morally speaking, we're obligated to fix this no matter what the cost. Even if it's our own timeline.
Well, we just gotta stay cautious then. We don't want to cause any more ripples now, do we?
Thank you, Doctor. Glad you're on board. I can't imagine this being pleasant for you after everything that's happened to you. Especially after everything you just went through, I'm forever grateful.
The doctor really did a number on you.
Oh, it's more than a number, all right. Mentally, that is.
Well, in any case, guess we'll save this boat adventure for another time. Allons-y!
Thank you. no.
Doctor? Requesting permission to enter your quarters?
Permission granted.
You can't hear them, correct?
Not just hear. I can sense it. Remembered it. It's like I was actually there, but not me. The hypocrisy's driving me nuts.
In spite of this, we have an advantage!
I can only hear bits, pieces of it. I can tell they're planning against me, but it's not like I know what! That guy with the top hat, he's real clever. Gotta look out for him.
He is fruitless against you, Lord! It would be senseless to concede!
Then what other options do we have? Sooner or later, they'll catch up! They'll find a way to stop their adversary. They always do.
Panic is futile!
Yeah? And why's that, huh? Oh, please, do enlighten me, strategist.
They are not the Lord. The Lord has acquired the trait of selfishness, which is what your former selves lack. Their impertinence will inevitably be captured in our hands. We will turn them in just as the Lord planned.
Yeah, I'm not so sure of that, but you're right. We've gone this close. So, it must be a sign that we must stop them. The universe would have wanted this. It is what it desires. I have to continue. I must resume and to think. Those doctors wanted to stand in my way, all for this universe.
And they shall be stopped. And I have the perfect plan for us to execute!
Well, we have no time to waste. We've got to stop them.
Come on, old girl. Yeah, I don't like it either, but we got to go.
I'm probably guessing she didn't like that.
Wouldn't blame her. You know, with you being on our time stream and all, and me not supposed to be here.
Yes, I'm sorry about that.
We can't do anything about it now if we just sit here. Let's take a look-see.
The year is correct. We're in 2026. Left thing to speculate now is where we are. Based on the designs of the building, it appears it's an apartment of sorts, but a desolated one.
Downing Street.
I'm sorry?
That's the name. It says so on the big street sign over there. It appears that this place was abandoned. Could have been a graveyard.
So why bring us here?
I don't know. All I did was punch in the year and the planet as you told me. Your guess is good as mine.
Help. Somebody help me.
Where on earth is that coming from?
Help. Somebody help me.
Over there. By that door.
What could be inside the dorm?
Possibly her.
This could be a trap.
Not good. His.
So, no one's in trouble?
Only one way to find out.
Oh, great. Couldn't have landed your TARDIS somewhere else, couldn't you?
No! We're locked in.
Help. Somebody help me.
Let me try. That's fantastic. The door's deadlock sealed. Worst of all, it's made of wood.
Oh, why are you saying that like it's a bad thing? Spooky apartment in a spooky street. Can't compare to the Titanic.
Help. Somebody help me.
Never mind that for now. She's coming from upstairs. Let's hurry!
Help me, please. I can't find my son.
Don't worry, Mom. We'll find your son. But first, you've got to tell me your name.
Oh, now you want to save me, Doctor?
What?
How do you know his name?
The same way I know yours. Killer.
The oncoming storm, destroyer of worlds. Such a fitting title.
What the?
She's a hologram. This was a ploy to lure us.
That hologram has a name. Stay right where you are, doctors. Don't even think about escaping.
Wait a second, who are you?
You see that woman behind you? That's my sister Marie. Well, till she died visiting my work at UNIT during the same day you arrived at Earth with your Dalek army.
Daleks? He's working with them?
As if you're surprised.
Wait! If you're part of UNIT, then that means you must know the Brigadier. Can you please get us in touch with her? She'll help us either way.
Yeah, I don't think I can arrange that.
Why not?
In the words of your former lover, spoilers. Don't even think about leaving this room. UNIT force field, designed for any alien class, especially for rotten Time Lords like yourselves. I thought I'd use you for blackmail, maybe to leverage your future self to pardon my nephew.
Your nephew? I'm assuming that's Maria's son.
Yes, and he was with Marie that day, and I have no idea where he is. How can I? Had to hide myself in this godforsaken apartment after that, barely making any contact with the outside world. Do you know what it's like to live on the burden?
I would be lying if I said I don't. And I'm sorry you made you live through that.
I know you are, and I can't deny that you sound very sincere, but sorry isn't going to fix this.
We know! We can help you! Let us go!
You think I let someone like you go?
This is a message from the Dalek race. Our scanners have picked up three life forms inside. We know you're inside. Resistance is futile. Refuse and we shall execute an assault, dispatching millions of our soldiers. You are defenseless.
They found us. It's over. It's all over.
Hey, come back. What about us?
Forget it. He's long gone. Looks like we're on our own.
No response, strategist! I am permitting dispatch, but refrain from firing. The Time Lords must remain. Dispatchers, engage within the premises. We will obey!
Dalek's coming in red hot. Hold on. Are those Gallifreyan weapons? Where did they get Gallifreyan weapons?
They must have gotten it from our future self.
Nonetheless, we're definitely outnumbered. We just need to find a deterrent to their attack. We need a diversion of some kind.
I have a proposition of sorts, but I doubt if you like it. In fact, you're probably going to think I'm crazy of sorts.
Would be a hypocrite if I deny it. What do you suggest?
You're not going to like it, but it's the best and potentially the only chance we have against him.
You're right. I don't mind where this is going, but I guess we've got no other choice.
Row 11, secured strategist! We have found no life forms! Resume search! They could not have gone far! Strategist, an incoming transmission! It is from the Lord! Put him on speaker! We've detected two Time Lords in Downing Street! Our dispatchers are finding them as we speak!
I know it's them. I just know it. I'll arrive as soon as I can.
Oh, Daleks! We're in here. Completely vulnerable. Come and get us.
Strategist! We have found... I know! Shall we secure the room? Negative! I shall go in alone! Strategist, it is the Doctor! Cease your concerns or you shall be expelled from this fleet! I obey!
My, it's true. You're working for him. How did he get you?
The operative question is why did you come to me? Giving up yourselves is not something the Doctor would do!
We'll cut right to the chase. You see, the Gallifreyan weapons that he provided for you consist of sufficient energy to penetrate the force field permanently.
so you need me to get you out?
If you're willing to cooperate, that is.
I only serve the Lord!
I'm not going to ask you a second time. Let us out, or else his life will be.
Please, I'm begging you. Do as he says.
On the other hand, Doctor, I refuse.
But if you do so, he'll never come to be. Is this what you want?
Then you shall succeed. After all, you are appalled by his actions, correct? Killing him means there's no you, and no you means no him. What is keeping you from getting what you want? I shall not stop you!
Doctor! You madman! Please, stop!
Weak little Time Lord! Besides your pettiness, you are just like the Lord, doing what it takes to get what he wants. Potentially a duplicate, an equivalent, even.
You have no idea what I'm like. I'm nothing like you.
Stop! The force field's down. Let's go.
I'm sorry.
No time for that now. There's an opening underground. Let's hurry.
We need to keep running.
You know, stupid wouldn't even be close to describe what we just did.
Be thankful we got out alive. That is what is important.
That wasn't part of the plan. You could have killed me. We had a contingency plan. If the Dalek doesn't budge, you let it go. But no, you decided to let your emotions get the better of you.
Oh, please. Your intelligence is more or less competent compared to mine. I've been around long enough to know what I am doing.
Oh, okay, Gramps, then answer this. What would happen if the quake did not disrupt the force field? What would happen if there was no other way out? The Sonic mushing my head will depend on your grasp. Would you let go?
Do I need to repeat myself? Because like I said, I knew what I was doing.
Time would have been at stake because of your remorse. It's bizarre enough that you're stuck in our time stream, especially when you're interfering with the life of a past incarnation.
Time? It's all that matters to you, isn't it? What about all the other lives the Doctor's endangered? Rose, Martha, even Susan. They would have been better off without us.
Look, I know that dumping yourself in our time stream is hell enough, but you need to stay with the task in hand.
How can I, Doctor? How can I? Everything that has ever happened within our lives is playing in my head all at once, past and future, especially with him being part of our lives.
I know, but that's no excuse. You in our time stream was already bad enough before you worsened it. Right. After we're done escaping, I'll go back to my TARDIS and get the hell out of this time period. Because if we don't... Do you hear that?
No, please.
Dale?
First the vortex manipulator, now you guys.
Hold on, let me help. Give me your device. You used to summon that hologram of yours.
Why should I?
Exterminate!
All right, here.
Right. Now, if I can amplify the speaker's module here and adjust the coordinates 50 meters west, where I can place your voice...
All right, here.
Impossible! There is no way you have relocated yourself so quickly! You shall not escape! You shall not escape!
Look, I don't know how you did that, but you helping doesn't change anything between us.
Something went wrong with your vortex manipulator, is that correct?
Yes, that's what I said.
If you hand it to me, I can fix it in a jiffy.
Wow, hold on. Are you really suggesting using a vortex manipulator to get out of this place?
I'm sorry, but we can't resort our lives to any half measures anymore. As
as hypocritical as this may seem, we have to do this.
And what makes you think I'll comply?
Listen, that Dalek out there chasing our Echo isn't going to be derailing for long. They'll ultimately untangle their ruse, and it won't be long till they come back, regardless of how you feel about me. I'm the best chance at survival.
Of course. You're the one who saves me. Fine, just make it quick.
I can see you've already set the coordinates.
If you must know, that's where my family lives. Now, are you done yet?
Almost there. It's ready now. I'll just press that button here.
Exterminate! Exterminate!
Come on, Doctor, latch on!
I've got to stop listening to you.
That's odd.
Wait a minute. We're back at the apartment. Doctor, did you make an error through your calculations?
That was no error.
There was no error indeed!
Oh, great. Congratulations, Doctor. You made us fall into their trap.
Oh, Doctor. Can you blame him? I mean, he's clever and all, but the time stream is absorbing him like a sponge.
Dale! You said it yourself! That man is a lunatic! What has he got to offer?
Something you don't have.
I've already transferred you the coordinates to your escape pod, along with your nephew. I'm sorry, but we couldn't bring your sister.
I see. And you're ensuring he's unarmed.
100%! As long as you promised you'd never return to Earth. If my armada ever sees you near my planet, ever again, they will not hesitate.
I understand. Goodbye, doctors. Hope we never see each other again.
Be honest with us. Did you really take him to that shuttle or decisive him to where he'll meet demise?
What's the point of asking? It's not like you'll ever believe me anyway. Do a coin flip and see what happens. After all, I'm the doctor who disappoints his past.
Understatement of the decade.
You're one to talk. You're the one who deliberately led both of your companions right to the friend zone.
It wasn't deliberate.
Maybe not. But it's not like you didn't know. It's not like you can make up for it. Speaking of companions, I got something to show you.
Yeah, and what would that be?
Actually, Trenchcoat, the surprise is actually for Top Hat over there. In fact, I think you'll love this one.
Is that Laurel? You killed her! You killed the Brigadier! How could you, you monster!
She was in my way, Doctor. I simply got her out.
Do you realize what you have done? We have killed a lot in our past, but what you just did makes a typical murderer look too kind. In fact, it's betrayal!
Oh, you don't like your gift, but I worked so hard on it. I even prepared a little extra just for you.
And what would that be? You showed the corpse of one of my dearest and most trusted allies who you have just killed. What can be more taunting than the Julia? You found her body?
Not just found, interacted as well. You may say we had a little altercation.
What kind of altercation?
She was alive this whole time, Doctor. Alive and well, even in your own future.
Impossible. She died in the Big Bang.
Or maybe that's how she wanted you to think.
No.
She was in my way as well, Doctor. I knew it had to be done. We both did.
Doctor?
So, you killed her. After everything she's done for you. After everything she's done for us!
This time, Doctor, I can assure that her demise was deliberate and very real.
You didn't have to!
I did, though. So what are you gonna do about it?
Doctor, you gotta calm down. Ah, oh, what the bloody hell?
The time stream can be utilized for anyone's advantage, even against its user. You have shown us that. You have gifted us the capability to exploit that.
You see? He wasn't supposed to know. Our time stream knew that as well. Stuck in an indefinite paradox loop, turning into this thing and back into himself again, ultimately demolishing our time stream as a whole. Unless...
a quantum tunnel transporter.
Send him back, and his memories of this will be erased. It will transport him right before he's ever met me like this, encase him back into his time loop as he's supposed to be. As will you.
You mean, I can't remember this either?
I'm afraid so.
The device is programmed to not send the target, but its user as well. You must use it.
There's no other way, is there?
Correct.
You know, Doctor, I might have lost my companions, but at least I can accept things that I can't change. Rose and Martha may have been misled, but they made a choice to travel with me. And then they let go. So I did too.
I guess that's what makes us different. You allowed evil like the Master to exist, to wreak havoc on Earth. I love the planet too much to let go.
Don't forget that I also didn't kill my friends on purpose. Even if they get in the way. I don't know who you are anymore. But you're definitely not the Doctor.
You're mistaken. I'm more of the Doctor than you ever were. Now, I believe your time is almost up, Trenchcoat. I shall bid you a proper farewell.
Lord, we have located his TARDIS!
Teleport the vessel nigh to my private chambers. I want to bid it a proper farewell.
I obey! Teleportation commenced!
Been ages since I've seen that desktop theme. I always appreciate a classic. Oh, this takes me back.
Makes me feel like I was him again. Oh, the adventures I had. All those battles. The loss. But things change. For the better. For humanity's sake. I can't go on like this. Those were the days.
I wish I could, though. But they're long gone. Saving the universe, getting a cup of tea afterwards, it was more than quintessential. It was living, but that won't be enough. Won't it? Oh, it never is. It never was. All the pain I suffered was for nothing!
The pain we've suffered. And that's how it is. For now. Until I can make it enough. I can make this world better. I will make it better. No more repeated chicanery. This time. My past will not get in the whatnot. Nor the future. All that matters is what happens now, and I know how it's going to end.
Thank you.
You have just listened to Doctor Who, The Classy Doctor Chronicles, Season 2, Episode 3, Evil on Downing Street. This audio was written by Daniel, and stars Isaac Travers as the Classy Doctor, Phoenix 24 as the 10th Doctor, Lacron Williams as Dale, Iris Prindle as the Last Doctor, Connor J. Sumner as the Daleks, and Melanie Eyeball as Woman. This audio's cover artist was Iris Prindle. This audio was edited by Iris Prindle. This audio was directed by Iris Prindle and produced by Iris Prindle and Isaac Travers. Thank you for listening to a Grammarco production.